Hybrid simulation is a structural testing technique that combines physical testing and computer modeling, offering a more efficient and affordable way to examine how structural systems respond to realistic dynamic loading. Rather than testing a complete structure on a large-scale physical test rig, hybrid simulation instead suggests modeling the complete structure while physically testing only a portion. For example, let's take a look at this full-scale concrete bridge. Testing the complete structure in a lab setting is nearly impossible, but through the use of hybrid simulation techniques, a single portion can be isolated and then tested in a laboratory, while a computer model is used to simulate the remaining portions of the structure. In real-time hybrid simulation, a recorded dynamic event, such as an earthquake time history profile, is used as a step-by-step command waveform. In each time step, the computational substructure is first analyzed by solving the associated equations of motion. Calculated displacements at the interfaces are then imposed on the physical substructure using actuators. Finally, the interface forces are measured and fed back to the computational substructure to calculate the evolution of the next time step displacement response. This process is repeated in real time for the entire time history profile. The enforced real-time test condition enables the method to capture rate-dependent dynamics of mechanical systems, such as the inertial effects and advanced damping systems not typically seen in static testing. For this demonstration, we will show a basic two-actuator biaxial test rig. We are testing on a steel rod, which could represent a beam or column in a larger structure. This test features MTS model 242 actuators and 252 servo valves, which give a maximum force of 4.5 kilonewtons and maximum displacement of 150 millimeters. The same test procedure is applicable to larger scale structural testing with much higher actuator capacities that MTS offers. An MTS FlexTest controller and test PC are being used to control both actuators simultaneously. MTS 793 controller software is used to drive commands and provide control feedback in displacement, load, or acceleration control. A high-speed XPC target real-time system is used to program the advanced control algorithms for high-precision motion control of actuators, as well as to define the experimental control methods to enforce the computational substructure being analyzed under real-time conditions. The data communication between the MTS FlexTest controller and the XPC target uses ScramNet reflective memory technology, which transfers data using fiber optic cable nearly instantaneously. MTS recommends OpenSees as the primary solution for the finite element modeling of the computational substructure. This is an open source program developed by the University of California, Berkeley. Berkeley also developed OpenFresco, which is a middleware program between the computational modeling domain and physical testing domain. MATLAB Simulink is the program interface for XPC Target. The communication between OpenSees and MTS 793 software is repeated for each time step in the command waveform. Installed systems can be modified to run alternatives to the OpenSees FEA modeler, including Abacus, MATLAB Simulink, or LS-DYNA. In this demonstration, you will learn how to set up a structural model, input an earthquake time history profile, set up a predictor-corrector algorithm, run the physical MTS test rig, and analyze and animate the data.
Opening the OpenSees Navigator software. Here we have a two-story by two-bay frame structure that was fully defined earlier. OpenSees allows you to create a 2D or 3D structures with any number of degree freedom and boundary conditions. If we review our model and select Define, in OpenSees it allows you to define any material properties and different section properties and elements. And once our model is fully defined, we need to define the experimental element, which you can see here. That is what we are defining as our physical sample in the test rig, labeled here as experimental element 01. So the rest of structures are all modeled with computational elements. Since OpenSees will be used to give commands to our physical test rig, we have to define a load pattern and external controller. So we are going to first explore the time history of the earthquake record in the both X and y directions. And next, we will select the controller used for this test under the experimental control. In this real-time application, we are using an XPC target control as our external control method. As you can see, we need to define the IP address and the port number of the target machine that will be used to execute the real-time code. Next, we will review the Simulink real-time model that will be running on XPC target. There are three major components here. The first one is the I/O blocks, which maps the control channels between the MTS FlexTest controller and the XPC target. The second is this predictor corrector algorithm, which enforces the computational substructure responses are synchronized in real time with the physical substructure testing. The third one is this outer loop actuator control compensator algorithm, which is used to improve the actuator tracking control for minimize the system delay, which is detrimental to real-time hybrid simulation by introducing negative dampings. To start the test, we must first go into our MTS793 control software and turn on the hydraulic power and hydraulic service manifold here. In the real-time application, we will load the MTS multi-purpose testware software and create an external command here as our drive profile. This enables the XPC target to send external command signals to drive our MTS controller and the physical test rig. So after we start it, we can bring the actuator back to zero if it's not already there in both X and Y direction. Next, we go back into the Simulink software. We need to build this model, the block diagram model, on the host PC and transfer the code onto the XPC target. Then we'll go back to the MATLAB environment. And what we are going to do is we will close the connection between the host PC and target PC. Therefore, the enabled OpenSys triggered the execution of the XPC target code. Now that all the supporting programs are ready and hydraulic power is on, we can go back into OpenSys and run the hybrid simulation. We can click the red Run OpenSys button, and the computational model we defined earlier will now run as our actuator drives. Once we acknowledge the system initialization checks, OpenSys will give step-by-step command to drive our test. Here we can see the live real-time response plot for the XY displacement versus time, as well as the force versus displacement hysteresis plot. Now the test has completed, we can run some post-process analysis tools in OpenSys. First, we can load the results by click the load button. After we load our test results, the analysis tools becoming enabled. And now we can take a look at the animation of the structure response under this earthquake. I will make this vibration magnitude by a factor of 10 in order to make the structure response more noticeable. And then we can start the animation. And in the meanwhile, if we want to take a look at the data, we can also go back to the plotter and look at the XY displacement response at the interface node. So this plot is coming from the numerical substructure analysis, and this plot is from the physical measurement of the physical substructure. So these two curves are correlating with each other.
MTS Systems is a leader in structural and seismic testing, offering turnkey solutions for hybrid simulation tests. As demonstrated during this video, MTS proprietary 793 software interacts seamlessly with various advanced modeling software packages, such as OpenSeas. MTS has also sourced appropriate high-speed target PCs and ScramNet data cards for implementing real-time calculations. MTS has expert applications expertise and is well connected with top hybrid simulation developers such as the University of California at Berkeley, Swinburne University in Australia, the National Center for Research on Earthquake Engineering, ENCRE, in Taiwan, and many more. Introductory packages are available from MTS, and even more advanced testing can be done with larger test frames and additional MTS actuators. For more information, please contact your local MTS representative.